हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू दिस थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ लेसन फेडरलिज्म। इन दिस वीडियो विल कवर द हेडिंग हाउ इज फेडरलिज्म प्रैक्टिस्ड। टिल नाउ वी हैव स्टडीड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ फेडरलिज्म, की फीचर्स ऑफ फेडरलिज्म एंड व्हाट मेक्स इंडिया फेडरल country. Now let's see how federalism in different parts of the world practiced. Look at some of the major ways federalism practiced in India. We are going to talk about India and how it is practiced in India. First basis is linguistic states. Linguistic on the basis of language. Whenever any state is formed on the basis of language, that state is known as linguistic state. In the year 1947, you know very well, it was our freedom year, the boundaries of several old states of India were changed in order to create new states on the basis of language. This was done to ensure that people who spoke the same language lived in the same state. So as I told you, these states were formed according to their language. This was done to ensure that people who spoke the same language lived in the same state. Marathi in Maharashtra, Gujarati in Gujarat, Tamil in Tamil Nadu, in the same way. Let's see the Indian political map of that era based on language. This is given in your book. Some states were created not on the basis of language but to recognize differences based on culture, ethnicity or geography. But some of them were not based on, not created on the basis of language, but to recognize differences based on culture. Their cultures were different, ethnicity, their rituals, their clothes, as well as geography. Geographically, they were different than other states. These include states like Nagaland, Uttarakhand, and Jharkhand, having different culture, different ethnicity, and geography. Experience has shown that the formation of linguistic states has actually made the country more united. It has also made administration easier. More states on the basis of language has made the country more united. It has also made administration easier. So it is easy to administer those states as well. Now next heading is language policy. What is language policy? How many languages are there in India? So let's see. Our constitution did not give the status of national language to any language. There is no national language in India. We have a working language, official language, but not the national language. Hindi was identified as the official language, but Hindi is the mother tongue of only 40% of Indians. Only 40% of Indians speak Hindi. Remaining 60% other language, Marathi, Gujarati, Tamil, Telugu, and many more. Therefore, there were many safeguards to protect other languages. So, those 60%, those people who were in 60% were opposing, were safeguarding their languages. Besides Hindi, there are 21 languages. In all, there are 22 languages recognized as scheduled languages by the constitution. So, how many languages are there in constitution? As scheduled languages, 22, including Hindi. A candidate in an examination conducted for the central government positions. For central government examination, a candidate may opt for any language out of these 22 languages to take the examination in any of these 22 languages. The states too have their own official languages like Tamil Nadu, then Karnataka, Odisha, Maharashtra. They have their own official languages. Much of the government work takes place in the official language of the concerned state. Most of their work is done in their own language of that concerned state's language. Now, center state relations. What are center state relations and how it has been since India got freedom? Before that, first of all, we'll talk about what is a coalition government. What is a coalition government? A government formed by the coming together of at least two political parties. Whenever two or more political parties come together to form a coalition, that kind of government is known as coalition government. Usually, partners in a coalition form a political alliance and adopt a common program. So, they adopt a common program. Their interests are similar. Now, as you can see in the picture, there are two caricatures given. In the first one, this is the time before 1990s, when Union government, central government has extreme power. They had extreme power. And as you can see in the cartoon, powers of the states were provided by central government. And state governments were seen taking bowls and making a line for the power. Now let's see the second caricature, that is about coalition government. Coalition government, you can see different symbols of different parties. So this is a cartoon related to coalition government, when two or more parties allies together and form a government. Some more important facts. In those days, the central government would often misuse the constitution to dismiss the state. As I told you, in before 1990s, central government used its power and misused the constitution to dismiss the state governments that were controlled by the rival parties. So if there was their own party in states, no problem at all. But if they were in opposition, they were rival parties, they misused their power. Who? Central government and authorities. So state governments were not given proper rights. This undermined the spirit of federalism. So this undermined the very spirit of federalism. All this changed significantly after 1990. As I told you, it changed after 1990. This period saw the rise of regional political parties in many states. So there came the regional political parties. You will study more about it in political party chapter. This was also the beginning of the era of coalition governments. So parties started coming together. This was the beginning of coalition government at the center. Since no single party got a clear majority, why was there a need of coalition government? Because not a single party got a clear majority. In the Lok Sabha, the major national parties had to enter into an alliance with many parties, including several regional parties, to form a government at the center. So it was required, a coalition government was required to form a stable government at the center. So that's all in this video. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.